Hey guys, welcome to the Horror Show. I'm Cecil Laird.
And I'm Jaime and Fuego.
And we're jumping into our spoiler review of The Possession of Michael King. Jaime, what do you want to talk about first, spoiler-wise?
Oh, there's lots of fun spoilerific stuff in this one. Most notably, that he starts hearing voices initially in the film after consulting his mediums and, you know, different satanic worshippers and stuff like that. He goes to a gentleman who's like kind of a recording producer who says to him, "There's no way that this voiceover work that you have given to me could have been made by a human. Like, there's no way possible."
Yeah.
Because we're talking pitches up to here.
He's like, "What equipment did you use?" Because
yeah.
I don't
How
know
did
if
you
I
alter
could have
your
done...
voice?
Yeah, yeah.
And that actually, you're led to believe as the audience that, you know, that's demons talking to him at that particular point. However, it's not.
Actually, the voices that he hears towards the beginning, he hears a singular voice later on when the demon is sort of fully taking over. The demon even tells him the voices that he was hearing to start were actually the voices of angels warning him against continuing his pursuit. And that was just a really cool twist.
Absolutely.
The fact that it was a choir of angels trying to stop him from getting further into it. And
when
of course
you kind
he didn't
of wonder
listen.
Initially if it was the cacophony of noise from the demon that they talk about early in the film when he encounters the sex-crazed demon worshippers who
exactly.
have like an orgy around him practically.
Yeah.
And yeah, pretty
blood
intense.
Orgy.
Blood
yeah,
orgy.
Yeah,
yeah,
exactly. I know you also mentioned
as
the
he
dog.
Makes his descent, you know, the beloved family dog, unfortunately, anytime when an animal bites it in a horror film, it always hits the heart pretty hard.
Yeah.
And he slaughters the family dog at one point, doesn't remember it because the demon is taking hold of him at that point and kind of taking over his body as he's falling into sleep, awakens in a trance, and goes and does terrible things like peeking in on the underwear of his sister and
yeah
pretty slimer,
pretty gross. So the dog has disappeared for a little while, and then he has these visions of blood or whatever in his daughter's room, and when he goes up, they're not sure what to see because there's blood everywhere, and it turns out it's not the daughter that he's hurt.
Which is what you think at first.
It's what you think at first under the covers, but then he pulls the covers back and it's the completely mangled dog. So
yeah,
that was definitely an effective reveal.
It's
yeah.
sad. Yeah.
Yeah, it is. And but speaking of sad, things do not turn out well for Michael King and his daughter. What ends up happening, Jaime?
You kind of start hoping. He's consulting different you know, people from the church saying, "I need an exorcism," and you start to wonder, is he going to make it? Are things going to be okay for this guy? And unfortunately, it's not the case. He ends up kind of sacrificing himself, you know, to save his daughter, because he kills his sister, holds her up like Kane from the World Wrestling Federation, and cracks her neck and throws her down, and then goes up to kill his daughter. And he at least is able to take hold enough there near the end through the help of his deceased wife, right? Who kind of makes an appearance.
The spirit
there at the end,
shows
the spirit.
Up, and he ends up throwing himself out a window,
yeah.
sacrificing himself, but at least that way the daughter lives.
Horribly traumatized for the rest of her
yeah,
life.
Yeah, most likely, you know, surprise, surprise.
It was good that not what the audience expected, at least for me as I watched it, happened every time. You know,
yes.
you're like, okay, this is a cliched premise, this is going to happen, and then when it took a twist, you're like, okay.
Absolutely.
This is good.
Pleasant surprise.
Damn right.
Again, you guys, that was The Possession of Michael King. Thanks for watching the spoiler review. Remember to check out our podcast or email us. The links to both of those are down below in the description.
And we also have Facebook for you to check us out on, and Twitter, @HorrorShow666, so follow.
And remember, guys, stay scared.